Yo, welcome back to the channel, all my creative people. I got this mic right here because I just recorded this whole video, and the other mic that I use, my Rode Video Mic Pro Plus, was dead. So the whole video has to be shot over again. So now we got a mic right here. I think it looks cool in the frame, whatever. We're gonna roll this video again. Welcome back to the channel, guys. Welcome back to the office. I just got back from a trip for my birthday. It was my birthday, September 26th. We went down to the Gulf of Mexico, me, my brother kid Nick, and my son Ace. I'm sure you all know both of them. Really nice place we stayed at. We also went on a boat ride. It was just a bunch of cool stuff. If you follow me on Instagram, you may have seen a couple IG stories from that. I kind of shot some stuff that I wanted to make into a vlog, but I don't know if I'm gonna make it into a vlog. And while I was down there, I was thinking, like, maybe I should make a video for people that want to learn how they should be vlogging and why they should be vlogging. First of all, let's talk about what a vlog is. A vlog is a video log, which means it's kind of like a journal. You're logging everything that you're doing that day, that event, that week, that month, I don't know, whatever it is that you choose to do. If you do a weekly vlog, a monthly recap vlog, a daily vlog, whatever, there are multiple ways that you can do it, and it's all up to you. But you're basically logging your day or logging your week, and you're just filming things that are happening, things that are on your agenda. It could be a trip. You could be going somewhere like I just did. I went to the Gulf of Mexico for my birthday. It could be a trip. It could be just a day in your personal life, you going hitting the gym and then going to test out a new camera that you just bought or a new lens. You could do any style of vlog, and it's basically up to you whether you do personal, professional, or both. Me personally, I like to do both. I vlog personal stuff with me and my son or trips. I vlog stuff when I'm doing music video shoots or photo shoots when I'm testing out cameras. So I do professional and personal. So there's a couple different ways or styles that you can vlog. One of which is just filming in real time, talking, checking in. Hey, we're out here doing this right now. We're getting some shots, and then show what you're doing. And then maybe later that day you do something else. It could be something like that. Very simple, straightforward vlog. The second way you can vlog is you can just do B-roll. You can shoot a lot of B-roll of cool cinematic looking stuff and then drop some music underneath it that fits that mood and that tone and that vibe, and that can be a cinematic vlog. Three, you could do both. You could do some talking to it and then get some cinematic stuff with music, end it out, cut to the next scene. Maybe the next day you waking up, talking to the camera, talking about what you're doing, showing what's going on. It can be any type of way that you want to make it, from cinematic and straightforward, just talking to the camera style vlog. That's basically what I do. Four, another way that you could vlog is like this. Sit down in front of your camera and tell a story and then lay some cinematic B-roll, or it could just be your phone footage or any type of footage that's covering whatever it is that you're talking about while you sit down and talk about it. Just like this, I could say, what's up guys, let me tell you about my story or what I did this week for my birthday trip. I was down in the Gulf of Mexico. I took my GoPro Hero 9 out with my son to the pool. We got some really cool shots. We actually went out on a boat ride for a sunset. It was really, really cool. We got some really good shots. We got some really cool pictures. Just a really amazing time. Also flew my drone a few times and got some cool little drone shots while I was out there, and that's it. And then you could end your vlog right there. You see what I did right there? I kind of just made a little mini vlog within this video. So that's another way that you can vlog. There's many different ways that you can do it. You can do it with like the captions at the bottom, kind of narrating what's going on. It's up to you. Speaking of music for cinematic vlogs and going underneath your vlogs, let's talk about the sponsor of this video. This video is sponsored by Soundstripe. So before you go anywhere, don't run, don't skip this. Just hear me out. Soundstripe is a subscription-based music library platform that is for YouTubers, creators, filmmakers, to get music from and use for vlogs, things like this. Sit-in videos just like this, or when you're out vlogging with your cinematic shots. And it's really important because the music is Soundstripe. They have tons of different music. They have different moods, different genres, all different types of music, which is really good for vlogs because a vlog is whatever you choose to be. And everywhere you go and everything that you shoot is gonna be different, and it's gonna require a different mood or a different type of music to bring together that feeling and emotion that you wanna give off in that vlog. So Soundstripe is a great place for that. They have tons of different music. They have curated playlists. They have sound effects, tons of sound effects. And they cost as low as like $11.25 a month. They offer a standard plan, a business plan, a premium plan, and they also have just a plan with sound effects, which can be really cool when you're making a cinematic sequence. I use Soundstripe for this video. I've been using them. They got some really cool music. They have 45,000 users. They have helped out 80,000 creators to date. So they're pretty reliable reliable source for music. They even sent me this cool hoodie, man. I'm really rocking with them. I'm a part of the Soundstripe family, and if you want to become a part of the Soundstripe family, you can click that link down below that I provided for you to get 20% off any of those plans that they offer that I was just mentioning. 20% off, good place, nice platform, sleek website, and they have really good music, like off the rip. If you just go to the homepage and click down the like featured music that they have, they're like bangers off the rip. So click the link down below, 20% off. Music is very important for vlogs to bring together that mood, that feeling that you want to give off, especially if you're doing cinematic vlogs. So in a vlog, what do you want to talk about? You could talk about anything that you want. You could talk about personal life stuff. You could talk about motivational stuff. You could talk about how to do things, DIY stuff. Vlogs are basically just mini stories. They're like little mini movies, regardless of if you're just talking to the camera or if you're doing cinematic stuff. So you literally can talk about anything. I personally choose to talk about some personal stuff and a lot of professional stuff. Professional stuff as in videography, photography, graphic designing sometimes, editing, all types of stuff. Professional stuff mainly, but I do add in a personal bit of stuff to my vlogs because I am the brand. The brand is me. It's totally up to you to choose what you want to show and what you don't want to show. If you don't want to show like personal stuff with your family, but you do a profession really, really well, you're really good at maybe cooking, or you're really good at shooting photography, and maybe you want to start showing some of that stuff in vlogs on YouTube. People love to see behind the scenes. People love to see the behind the scenes of what you do if you do something really good. So I think it's very important to start doing that if you do something professionally. That kind of is touching on the last part of this video, where we're gonna wrap up at, and it's why you should vlog, why I should vlog. If you do something professionally and you're really good at something, people are gonna wanna see more of the process when you're creating it, or what gives you your ideas or stuff like that. All that stuff is really, really like important to put into like a vlog form, because the people that follow you and love what you do, they're gonna wanna see that type of stuff, and they wanna see more, and they wanna get into it and feel it more. So those are great ways to vlog. And then even on a personal note, even on the personal side, if you wanna make vlogs about your personal life, you out jogging and then mix in some of what you do. Maybe you're a fisherman. Maybe you don't do it professionally. Maybe you just fish on the side, but you're really good at it. You could vlog while you go out on the boat, how your day starts, the meat of the video, when you're out there and you're catching a fish. Cool little stories are very important. People love a good story. If you want to do your personal life, it's okay to do that, because you have your own little unique personal story for every single day of your life. If you just do it just to have footage to look back on with your family, that's another very important reason why you and I both should be vlogging, because we do things every day with family, with friends, and it's good to look back on videos. So that's gonna be it for me, guys. Like I said, I hope that this helps you. I hope that this motivates somebody. I hope that it gave you some ideas or gave you some insight on how you should be vlogging. Drop us a comment if you have any other tips for people when it comes to vlogging. This is a community. It's a creative community. If you're new here, consider subscribing, and thank you for checking out the video. That's it. I'm done. This mic needs to go. Like, get off of me. Bye.